Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy with another in the series. Just a follow-up on the Walmart funnel recording horn, playback horn. It's been about an hour since I posted the video showing how to modify it. So the epoxy has cured, and as I said, it is a perfect fit on the recorder or the reproducer. It fits like it's made for it. It is absolutely precise fit. And it makes an absolutely excellent recording horn. And I'm going to do a quick recording on a black wax cylinder. We're going to record with this horn, and then we're going to play it back with this horn. And for being a transmission funnel, it sounds remarkably good. It sounds better than any witch's hat horn that you will ever find. Even if you could find one this long, this will sound better because it's made of a dense polymer. It makes you wonder, why don't they make these of a dense polymer? They could make them weigh half as much, and they'd cost $10 a piece. So, something to think about. But in any case, Walmart funnel has been modified for use on the Edison cylinder phonograph by one simple modification of adding that copper connector with a few drops of 5-minute epoxy, and then cutting off the hanging tab. So we're going to do a quick recording on a black wax recording blank, Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph. So this is my dedicated recorder. The machine is wound. We've got a black wax, freshly shaved cylinder on there. Start the machine. I'll just do a quick recording, and then we'll play it back through this transmission funnel. Greetings and salutations, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a quick recording with the newly modified Walmart transmission funnel. A simple modification of adding the copper coupler to the end of the funnel with a few drops of 5-minute epoxy. So once you've modified the transmission funnel, you can simply stick it on any Edison cylinder phonograph. It makes an excellent recording horn. It also makes a very effective and efficient playback horn. So just a quick recording on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph, recording with the Caniphonic New Spirit recorder on a black wax cylinder, and recording with the modified Walmart transmission funnel.
So, a really, really simple modification, as you can see. And as I said, you can spray that black, you'll never know it's been modified, or you can just wrap it with black tape. It works really well. And by tomorrow, this will be absolutely solid. And as I said, it fits perfectly on both the recorder and the reproducer. So let's pull the recorder off. Pull the cylinder off. A good loud recording, I can tell you that. Just by looking at the grooves. So we brush away our swarf, and as always, I always stress this, get as much of that particulate matter out of these freshly cut grooves as you can. Here's a good trick. Your swarf brush, breathe on it. That slight bit of moisture picks up every single little strand of that swarf and just really sucks it right out of the grooves. All right, put the cylinder back on the phonograph. We'll install a Model C reproducer. Using the transmission funnel as a playback horn, let's see how we did.
Greetings and salutations, Benjamin J. the Victrola Guy, making a quick recording with the newly modified Walmart transmission funnel. Simple modification of adding the copper coupler to the end of the funnel with a few drops of 5-minute epoxy. So once you've modified the transmission funnel, you can simply stick it on any Edison cylinder phonograph. It makes an excellent recording horn. It also makes a very effective and efficient playback horn. So just a quick recording on the Edison Standard B cylinder phonograph, recording with the Caniphonic New Spirit recorder on a black wax cylinder, and recording with the
Alright, so as you see, that simple modification and a $2 funnel gives you a working playback horn and a really effective and efficient recording horn. It looks strikingly similar to an original recording horn. It is very efficient as far as it sounds bigger than it is, and it's not tinny. It has a much different sound than a witch's hat horn, simply due to that dense polymer they use to make these horn or to make these funnels out of. So that simple modification, you now have approximately a $3 horn for your Edison cylinder phonograph that can do double duty. It'll make an effective playback horn, but it also makes a very efficient recording horn. So as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.